Hi everyone, welcome to S&S BioInfo. Today's topic is transport of water and minerals in plants. Transport of water and minerals in plants. The plants absorb water and minerals from the soil by means of roots. These water and minerals are transported to different parts of the plant, such as roots, stems, and leaves, with the help of specialized conducting tissues in vascular plant. Those specialized conducting tissues are xylem and phloem. Here, I am going to teach about xylem, its function in the plants. The word xylem is derived from a Greek word xylon, meaning wood. Xylem, the Greek word xylon, meaning wood. Xylem is a complex permanent tissue which is composed of four elements, that means four types of cells. They are xylem vessels, xylem parenchyma, xylem tracheids, and xylem fibers. Xylem vessels, xylem tracheids, xylem parenchyma, and xylem fibers. Xylem fibers. Xylem not only transport the water and minerals but also give the mechanical support to the plants. Here the xylem vessels and tracheids are mainly involved in the transport of water in vascular plants. Xylem vessels are involved in conduction of water. Then xylem parenchyma stores food, carbohydrate and oil, etc. Stores carbohydrate. While xylem fibers give mechanical support. Give support to the plant. So here you can see the cross section of a stem with the xylem and phloem. This is phloem, xylem. Then this part is called pith. The outer covering is epidermis. So phloem and xylem together termed as vascular bundles. Vascular bundles. Here the xylem vessels are elongated dead cells. It forms as a continuous tube and helps in the transportation of water. Similarly, the xylem tracheids are also elongated cells and form as a tubular structure. So the xylem vessels and tracheids form as a continuous network or channels to transport water and minerals from root to different parts of the plants. Now you listen me, I have done an activity to show the upward movement of water through xylem. For this I took one glass with water with a reddening solution, so the water is red in color. Then with the leafy twig of two plants. One is shiny bush plant. This is very familiar to you. This is the colloquial name is mashitando. Then another plant named balsam plant, and I dipped these plants for few hours. After few hours I could observe the reddish color in the stem as well as in the leaves. See, in the shiny bush plant also you can see the same. So red color in the stem. That means xylem transports the water in upward direction. Here at this tip also you can see the reddish color. That means it transports water in unidirectional pathway, that's only in upward direction. Now let's study the mechanism of transport of water and minerals through the xylem tissue. Mechanism of transport of water. Transport of water. The three mechanisms or three features are involved in the transport of water through the xylem tissue. They are root pressure, cohesion force, and transpiration pull. First one, root pressure. Second one, cohesion force. Cohesion force. Third, transpiration pull. Transpiration pull. First of all, root pressure. At the roots, the cells that in contact with the soil actively take up ions. This creates a difference in the concentration of these ions between the root and the soil. So water moves from the soil to the root xylem. Thus it creates an osmotic pressure. So root pressure. This root pressure pushes the water in upward direction as a steady column of water. Then how do these water molecules move as a steady column of water through the xylem vessels and tracheids? With the help of a force called cohesion force. Cohesion force is the mutual attraction between the water molecules, thus it forms a steady column of water. So this steady continuous column of water is transported as a tube through the xylem vessels and tracheids from root to the upward direction to different parts of the body. But this root pressure and cohesion force is insufficient to meet the requirement of large plants like trees, so that they have an alternative system to fulfill their needs, that is transpiration pull. You know that what is transpiration? It's the loss of water through the stomata from the leaves. So during the daytime, the transpiration will be high. The rate of transpiration is high. The loss of water from the leaves is high. To eliminate the difference, the water moves from the root to upper parts of the body and fulfill the requirements of the leaves. So, when the more water is lost through the stomata, the more force is created inside the xylem vessels. That is suction force. A suction force is created inside the vessels. Thus, it moves in upward direction in heights of large plants like trees. So, here we can understand that root pressure, cohesion force and transpiration pull are the three major forces drive the water molecules from the root xylem to the upper parts of the plants. I hope you got it. With this, I conclude my session. Then thank you and have nice moments.